Welcome back to my channel Whiteboard E-Learning. Dear student, today we will discuss from the chapter number 5, class 12, chapter number 5, that is magnetism and matter. So in this chapter, already I have given the introduction. Today we will cover here, I am writing one by one, that is the pole strength of a magnet, pole strength. Next, we'll study about the magnetic dipole moment, magnetic dipole moment. Next, number 3, Coulomb's law. In magnetostatics. Number 4, to find out the magnetic field strength, that is B, flux density B, due to a bar magnet at an, number 1, axial point, number 2, that is equatorial point. Okay, these are the topics today we'll cover. Now we'll start from the pole strength. So I'm writing here pole strength. So already we have previous chapter, we have covered the magnetic field line. So we deal with the magnet. Now I'm taking one bar magnet. So you know bar magnet has two poles. One is north pole and another is south pole. Suppose north pole is located here and south pole is located here. So that is actually known as the magnetic length. So magnetic length is lesser than the physical length or the geometrical length, and always it will be 6/7 of a geometrical length. Okay, so now if two magnets are coming closer, what will happen? You have already seen, suppose there is a magnet and come, we have brought another magnet near it. Then suppose if it is N pole, it is S pole. If it is N pole, if it is S pole, then there will be repulsion. And if instead of N pole, there will be S pole, one of the pole is S pole, then it will be attraction. So the strength of the repulsion, strength of the, you know, force applied on this system will depend on the pole strength, by which the strength of the pole has been defined, that is known as the pole strength. The two poles of a magnet are of equal strength. The pole strength is represented by small m. Okay. And the unit of this pole strength in SI system is ampere meter. Ampere meter. Okay. That is abbreviated as AM. So if we just compare with the electrostatics, you know there is a good relation in between the electrostatics and magnetostatics. In electrostatics, the charges play an important role, plus Q charges, minus Q charges, and here plus M and minus M. North pole, and it is the pole strength of a south pole, divided by plus M minus M. Now the magnetic dipole moment. Number 2, magnetic dipole moment. So you know a magnetic dipole moment consists of two unlike magnetic poles of equal strength separated by a small distance. So if we consider again one bar magnet and these two poles, you know, north pole and south pole of equal strength, so north pole and south pole, if they are equal in strength, suppose this is plus M and this is minus M, and unlike magnetic poles, unlike means this is a north pole, this is south pole. So what is magnetic dipole? So magnetic dipole is nothing but an arrangement where consists of two unlike magnetic poles, north pole and south pole, of equal strength, that is M and M, magnitude is equal, separated by a small distance, that is suppose 2L. So that arrangement is known as the magnetic dipole. Already in electrostatics, you have read about electric dipole, is not it? Electric dipole. At that time, you have seen plus Q, minus Q. They are separated by a distance, that is suppose 2L. Then dipole moment will be P is equal to either charges Q into 2L. And the directions of the dipole moment from negative to positive. Here also, magnetic dipole moment, here dipole moment M is equal to M into 2L. Here also, either pole strength into 2L. So now the directions of the magnetic dipole moment will be from S pole to N pole. Always S pole to N pole. Now we'll emphasize on the Coulomb's law of magnetostatics. Number 3, Coulomb's law in magnetostatics. So already we have read about in electrostatics, there is a formula, Coulomb's law formula, 1, that is 2, that is 1, 2, that is 3. F is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 Q1 Q2 by R square. Q1 and Q2, what role plays in electrostatics? M1 and M2 will play the same role in the magnetostatics. So here, if the two poles are separated, you know there is a thing, there is a difference in the electrostatic, plus Q charge and minus Q charge can be separated, but you know in the magnetic monopoles are not exist, but we are dealing with the theory, we are assuming that magnetic monopole exists. So that's why you have taken two poles, pole strength M1 and M2 separated by a distance, suppose plus 1, this plus 1, same, and the distance is here suppose R, then they will be repelled. So according to the Coulomb's law, this force of repulsion will be proportional to the product of their pole strength, that is M1 and M2, and it is also inversely proportional to the square of the distance between them. Then it will be F varies as M1 M2 by R square. Some constant will come, so some constant K M1 M2 by R square. So the experimental value of K is mu 0 by 4 pi. So here F is equal to mu 0 by 4 pi M1 M2 by R square. So we got on formula according to the Coulomb's law of magnetostatics, and it is analogous to the previous formula what we got in the electrostatics. That is F is equal to mu 0 by 4 pi M1 M2 by R square. Now we will apply the formula in the part, that is B due to a bar magnet at an axial point and to equatorial point. Now we will find out number 4, that is the magnetic field strength, magnetic flux density or magnetic induction field, that is B due to a bar magnet. You can see we have taken one bar magnet. This is the S pole, this is the N pole of equal pole strength, and they are separated by the distance 2L, and we have taken one point, that is P here. You can see this is the point P. This point P is on the axial point. These two points S and N we have connected by a straight line, and the P is on that line. So this is known as the axial point. The distance of the P point from the midway of the magnet, that is R. So at this point we have to bring one unit positive charge. So in the place of electrostatics, positive charge we have brought here north pole. So unit north pole, we have to bring one unit north pole. Okay, so if we apply the Coulomb's law of magnetostatics here, so we can get, so I'm writing here, so we are finding out the B, magnetic field strength B at a point, at an axial point P. Okay, magnetic force due to S pole. So we have placed here one unit north pole, So north pole will be attracted towards the south pole. Okay. So directions will be from P to S, and the force will be according to the formula, that is B2. You can see this is the force B2. Okay. Now B2 will be equal to mu 0 by 4 pi m into 1 by the distance in between them. What is the distance in between them? This is R, this is L. So it will be R plus L square along, we can write here, along PS. Okay. Now in a similar way, magnetic force due to north pole on the unit pole, which is placed in the P, that is B1. We can write here, that is B1, and you can see the B1, because we have placed here in north pole, unit north pole will be repelled by this north pole, so direction will be along NP. So now the magnitude will be mu 0 by 4 pi m on m2. Here it will be same m into 1, and the distance in between them total is R, and we have to subtract it this L from total R, so it will be R minus L square along N P. So from the figure we can consider that, we can assume that as north pole is very close to the P, so these forces will be, this magnetic force will be greater, because these forces actually the inverse square law maintains, the inverse square law, following the inverse square law. So if the distance increased, then the force will be decreased in a square law format. So from this realization we can see B1 is greater than B2. So what is the resultant force at point P on unit north pole? That will be, suppose resultant force will be, resultant force at P on unit north pole will be equal to B, is equal to B1 minus B2 is equal to mu 0 by 4 pi m by m minus L, sorry, R minus L whole square minus mu 0 by 4 pi m by R plus L square. So if we take common mu 0 m by 4 pi, so it will be R square minus L square whole square. So it will be R plus L whole square minus R minus L whole square. So we can write here mu 0 m by 4 pi R square plus 2 R L plus L square minus R square plus 2 R L minus L square by R square minus L square whole square mu 0 m by 4 pi R square, this R square, this R square, L square, L square. So we got here 4R, 2RL, 2RL, 4RL by R square minus L square whole square along which direction? So it will be along, you know, greater force is along NP direction. So resultant force will be also in the along NP, this NP direction. Now there is a consideration, if R is greater than L, then we can write here B is equal to mu 0 m by 4 pi, it will be 4 R L by R to the power. So if R is greater than L, then we can neglect the L, so it will be R to the power 4. So ultimately it will be 4L by R cube. So now we know from the magnetic dipole moment we got the idea m into 2l. So what is it? M into 2l, that is the magnetic dipole moment. Okay, and now it is mu 0 by 4 pi by r cube. So now we got mu 0 by 4 pi. So m into 2l is known as the capital M. So 2m. So capital M is known as the magnetic dipole moment. Already we have learned about magnetic dipole moment m. So m into 2l, m into 2l known as m. Okay, and by it will be r cube. So that is the final formula, mu 0 by 4 pi 2m by r cube. 4, magnetic field strength B, magnetic flux density or induction, magnetic induction field B at an equatorial point, that is also called tan B position, and the figure is, so now you can see again we have taken the magnet, bar magnet, and the intermediate distance between the poles are 2L, and we have taken a point P where the magnetic field flux density or field intensity we have to find out, that is the point P, that is this point, and this point actually perpendicular to the line joining S and M, and that point, that type of point are known as the equatorial point, that is the tan B position. So at this position, if we want to find out the magnetic field strength, then the same formula will apply and find out the magnetic field strength, resultant magnetic field strength. Now magnetic flux density, flux density at P due to north pole, N pole. So first we have taken this N pole. Okay, so it will be B1. You know, if we place here, so if we want to find out the field strength, so we have to put here one unit north pole. Okay, so if we place unit north pole here, you can see due to this north pole it will be repelled and it will going away from this north pole, and the directions will be along NP. So now that is B1, mu 0 by 4 pi, here M1 M2, here pole strength of N is taken as M, and pole strength of here we have placed here north pole, unit north pole, so it is 1, and distance between them, so what is the distance between them? So it is L, length is L, this distance we have taken as D. Okay, then this distance will be root over d square plus l square. So root over d square plus l square, then square, distance square along n p. Okay, now in the same way, magnetic field flux density at P due to south pole, south pole, that is b2, due to south poles, this is south pole, and you know we have placed here unit north pole, so it will be attracted towards this line. So now the force will be mu 0 by 4 pi, here also m into 1, m1 m2, by distance, the same distance here also, the distance will be same, so it will be d square plus l square, root over d square plus l square whole square along ps. So now you can see these two forces, B1 and B2, the magnitude of the two forces, B1 and B2, will be equal, similar. If we take the component of this B1 along this direction, so it will be B1 cos theta, it will be B1 sin theta. Again, the component of B2 along this direction will be B2 cos theta, and it will be B2 sin theta. And already we have written B1 is equal to B2, so these two forces, that is B1 sin theta and B2 sin theta, will be cancelled each other. So remains the remaining forces, magnetic flux density will be B1 cos theta, B2 cos theta. Okay. So now the resultant, now we can write resultant magnetic flux density will be equal to twice of b1 cos theta or b2 cos theta, whatever may be, two values are similar. So we can write here 2 into b1, that is mu 0 by 4 pi m by d square plus l square whole square. And the direction will be this direction. You can see it is along PT direction, along PT direction. So now we can write here 2 into, so cos theta will be there, cos theta. Now what is the value of cos theta? Value of cos theta, value of cos theta. It is known as the base by hypotenuse. What is the base? Base known as the L. Hypotenuse is known as D square plus L square. Okay. So now write here mu 0 by 4 pi M by D square plus L square whole square into L by root over D square plus L square. So now write here 2 mu 0 by 4 pi m l by d square plus l square whole to the power 3 by 2, 2 plus half, it will be 3 by 2 along pt. So you know m into 12, if you just rearrange the item denominator, so we can write here in this way mu 0 m into 12. So what is m into 12? That is the magnetic dipole moment m by 4 pi, it is d square plus l square whole to the power 3 by 2. So we are writing here mu 0 by 4 pi, it is capital M, by d square plus l square whole to the power 3 by 2 along PT. Here we have considered the same thing, that is D is greater than L. If we consider D is greater than L, then we can write here V, the resultant magnetic field B will be equal to mu 0 by 4 pi M by DQ. That means if we write in the place of D, that is R, as we already we have done in the previous axial point, that was R. So mu 0 by 4 pi m by R cube. If it is in the place of D, we can write R. Then it is the formula mu 0 by 4 pi m by R cube. Okay. So up to this student, if you have any question, then comment in the comment section of this video. Thank you for watching my video. If you think the video is helpful to you, don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe my channel for next upcoming videos from this chapter. Thank you.